A lot of people have been wondering how many CCP members are actually in MoHoYo, specifically as executives. And apparently, MoHoYo does have a CCP party branch in the company. To what extent that is, if it's true, I'm not really sure. And what pullover they have over the company, I'm not really sure either. But we have seen that MoHoYo likes to push back against the CCP on some level. So it makes everything very interesting. Now, making things even more interesting is that there was news that MoHoYo partners with Tencent, which reportedly agreed to reduce fees for Genshin Impact. This is a partnership in the sense that they're now listed on my app, Tencent's app store, for a 70% revenue split, meaning 70% goes to MoHoYo and 30% goes to Tencent. It's very interesting because previously we saw that Tencent apparently tried to buy a stake in the company of MoHoYo, and MoHoyo was like, nah. So I don't think it was just because that they had a bad deal from Tencent, potentially. Maybe it was a great deal, I don't know. But I think the main reason is that they didn't want Tencent to have any control over the company, especially because Tencent's ties to the CCP. However, here's where it gets crazy, because on October 27th, PingWest says, MoHoYo joins Alibaba, Tencent, picking Singapore as key international hub, which makes it look like MoHoYo is distancing themselves from the CCP even more, but also it makes it look like Tencent is too. And then, just the other day now, on November 25th from Niche Gamer, they say, Tencent banned from updating or launching apps by Chinese government in temporary administrative guidance. So it kind of looks like the CCP is retaliating against Tencent for that move to Singapore. At least that's something that we could certainly speculate on. And the big question next, would the CCP try to retaliate against MoHoYo on some level too? Because they also write, MoHoYo, the owner of Genshin Impact, is accelerating hiring in Singapore, becoming the latest Chinese company to deepen its operation outside the mainland and raise its bets on the key international hub. So yeah, I'm sure the Chinese Communist Party is not happy about any of that. But I guess we gotta wait and see if it ends up affecting MoHoYo. And yeah, let me know what you think in the comments about all that stuff. Thank you for tuning in. This will be the third and final segment of the day, but I look forward to catching you in the comments and also tomorrow for the next segment. Peace.